a fighter that you previously trained.
Yeah.
I think for one fight, Hank Lundy.
Yeah.
He suffered a first round knockout loss.
Yeah.
Last Saturday. Yeah. Now he's chosen to pack it in and retire.
Yeah.
What's your thoughts on it?
I mean, Hank one of them guys, man, started late. And by late, I mean about 18, 19 years old, started boxing. Turned pro probably after like a year or two fighting in the amateurs. Fought so many names. Fought on ESPN back when a lot of these dudes was in school. You know what I mean? A lot of these dudes was babies. And in school, Hank was fighting on ESPN. You know what I mean? Fought on HBO, fought on Showtime. Won most of the fights, lost some. You know what I mean? Been in there with great names. Put on great showings. You know what I mean? Been in a lot of controversial shit. Hank, what more could you want? You know what I mean? A lot of guys, of course, they don't want to go out with a loss, but Hank did his thing, though. The game will always remember Hank Lundy because he got some fights out here that, you know what I mean, you will never forget. So, to me, he had a great career. You know what I'm saying? And I'm just happy to say I witnessed it and I was somewhat a part of it. Because I used to spar Hank a lot, too. Spar Hank, you know what I mean? And I ended up training him for one fight against Shannara Bunt. Went the distance, 10 rounds, lost on the card. You know what I mean? But great fight. I mean, I just wish him the best. You feel me? The game, to be honest, the game need more guys like Hank Lundy. Hank Lundy got heart. Hank Lundy got more than heart, really. But, I mean, guys can learn from a guy like Hank Lundy. They don't want to believe it, but they can.
How often does a fighter get to go out with the storybook ending the way they want to go out?
Probably 20% chance. That you go out storybook. The reason
you go
I said
like
that,
Andre Ward, you go out like Floyd.
Yeah, that's probably like 20% of the guys go out with a win. You know what I mean? But a lot of guys go out their last fight and lost. You know what I mean? Shit like that. It happened to one of the greatest from Philadelphia, Bernard. You know what I mean? Got knocked out the ring and shit like that. But it happens. It's the game. You know what I mean? Everybody don't go out like that, but even still, it don't take away what you've done in the game. You feel me? Hank's a great fighter. He's gonna go down in the history book. Not just Philadelphia boxing, but in boxing, period. You know what I'm saying? Because for everybody he lost to, it was somebody he beat that was on that level as well. You know what I mean? Or that he beat. And all his losses wasn't losses.
No, there's a couple Jones I felt like
he got
robbed.
He got burned for sure. So, you know what I mean? Well, I wish you nothing but the best. You know what I'm saying? And whatever he pursued to do after this shit. You know what I mean? But I would have loved to have a career like him. You know what I mean? The reason I'm saying, because Hank fights, a lot of his fights was televised. A lot of my fights wasn't televised. I was fighting on small circuit shows and shit like that. If I had the chance to be fighting on HBO and shit like that, hell yeah. I wish I could have done it too. A lot of guys don't get to do that. So, you're going to hear a lot of bullshit talk, but, I mean, a lot of guys ain't been there, been where Hank's been, and done what he done.
As a fighter, when do you know it's time to pack it in?
I mean, when your body just took enough, your mind took enough, the people around you got to be honest and tell you it's enough. But it's hard to tell a fighter that because he's a fighter. You know what I mean? His job, that's not just his job, it's what he do, but that's what he is inside. You know what I mean? You got some men who are great at numbers and they great at counting. You got some men who are great actors. You got some men are great plumbers and construction workers and shit like that. And then you got men who fighters. You know what I mean? It's hard to tell a fighter, no. How you gonna tell a construction worker not to go make 10,000 real quick in a week? You know what I'm saying? How you gonna tell him that? How you gonna tell a writer not to write anymore? Even though their job is a lot different from ours, but this is what we do. When you're a warrior, it's hard to put your sword down. It's hard. You know what I'm saying? Because that's what you do. It's boring. Guys who are fighters and shit like that, and daredevils, it's boring just living a regular civilian lifestyle. Nobody wants to do that. You gotta be around this shit. You gotta smell this shit. That's why I be in the gym every day. I don't care about my record, none of that type shit. I love to fight. So I know any given day, if I wanted to get in the ring with any of these guys in here right now, they'd do it. You know what I mean? And that'd make me feel a lot better. So that's why I'm in the gym every day. I love this shit. You know what I mean?